Let's go ahead and create our first application in Flask. Create a file named project.py in the same directory as the database setup.py file. A minimal Flask application looks something like this. Let's take a look at this code together and see what's going on. First, I imported this Flask class from the Flask library. Next, I create an instance of this class with the name of the running application as the argument. Anytime we run an application in Python, a special variable called name gets defined for the application and all of the imports it uses. The application run by the Python interpreter gets a name variable set to __main__, whereas all the other imported Python files get a __name__ variable set to the actual name of the Python file. Next, I have this thing that looks like a function, but starts with an at symbol. This is called a decorator in Python. This decorator essentially wraps our function inside the app.route function that Flask has already created. So if either of these routes gets sent from the browser, the function that we define here gets executed. If this is difficult to follow, it's okay. I'll provide a link in the instructor notes if you're interested in learning more about decorator functions. Just know that this @app.route piece of code will call the function that follows it whenever the web server receives a request with a URL that matches its argument. So in this case, if we visit the root of my site at localhost port 5000 or localhost port 5000/hello, this hello world function will be invoked. Inside my hello world function, I return the message I want to display to the user's browser. Jumping to the last line of our code, I use the run function to run the local server with our application. The if statement here makes sure the server only runs if the script is executed directly from the Python interpreter and not used as an imported module. So basically, this line of code says, if you're executing me with the Python interpreter, then do this. But if you're importing me into another Python file, don't do this, but you still have access to the rest of the code. By default, the server is only accessible from the host machine and not from any other computer. This is the default, because in debugging mode, a user of the application can execute arbitrary Python code on your computer. Since we are using a Vagrant environment for this course, we must make our server publicly available by changing the call of the run method to look like this. This tells the web server on my Vagrant machine to listen on all public IP addresses. Restarting our server each time we make a modification to our code can get pretty annoying, but Flask can take care of this for us. If you enable debug support, the server will reload itself each time it notices a code change. It will also provide you a helpful debugger in the browser if things go wrong. I'll save this code as project.py in the same directory as my restaurant menu DB file and execute it with the Python interpreter. Visiting localhost port 5000 or localhost port 5000/hello, I see the output of my code. To stop the server, I hit Control C. So we see that with much fewer lines of code, I executed a similar version of our hello world from lesson 2. Notice that with Flask, we don't have to explicitly write out response codes anymore. You will soon see that this is just one of the several features frameworks take care of automatically for the developer.